Just this week, the Prime Minister made a commitment to the world to expand India's green cover. He said at the UN action meet being held at Greater Noida that India pledges 26 million hectares of land or to get under the forest cover by 2030. The commitment is huge, got a lot of applause from the international community. But just 50 kilometers away from that venue, here in Gurgaon, the BJP Haryana government has set out a legislature that plans to take away 60,000 acres of forest land and use it for development. The move has got major criticism from environmentalists, and now even the citizens are up in arms. We are here in Aravallis to find out what the deal is all about. In February this year, the BJP government in Haryana amended the Punjab Land Preservation Act, or the PLPA, a move that would open 33% of forest in Haryana for real estate. Students, parents, civil society and environmentalists came out in big numbers to oppose the amendment, but it was passed regardless.
So far, we've had the campaign in Gurgaon. So we started in January, we visited the Forest Minister, Mr. Narendra Singh, and we talked about the implications that the PLP amendment would have had. He told us that he would talk about the ill effects of the amendment in our favor, but the amendment will still pass.
Haryana has now come up with an amendment which will be retrospectively applied from 1966. So as a result, the Supreme Court judgments which make these areas a forest will become ineffective. Then there's nothing stopping Haryana from saying, well, this is, you know, prime land on the Delhi border, and let's do real estate. In fact, 350 acres where we are standing has already been auctioned off and tendered, and there was only one eligible bidder for that tender. It's a well-known real estate firm of Gurgaon.
To understand just how problematic this is, let's look at the map of Haryana. As you can see, there are just two major green patches here at Chandigarh and this area, which is Gurgaon and Faridabad. Haryana anyways has the lowest forest cover in the entire country. And now imagine losing even that.
These really are our lungs. They are our only oxygen producing area. They are also our only area where water is able to seep down into our... This range is really what protects us from our state from becoming a desert. And if these...
With Rajasthan on the other side,
and this is a range which has traditionally and over the years been your protection, which is why Haryana has not merged into the desert. So if we open this up for construction, then I think we will all be in a lot of trouble.
And it's not just that. The Aravalli forests are a biodiversity hotspot with over 400 species of native trees, shrubs and herbs uniquely adapted to the dry conditions, and over 200 bird species and wildlife, which the locals witness depleting already.
जो बदलाव मैंने देखा है कि माइनिंग के टाइम में उजड़ते हुए देखा है, फिर माइनिंग के बाद जंगल को रिकवर करते हुए देखा है. बहुत सिंपल है समझना कि वो बिल्डिंग जो है वो यहाँ तक लाना है सरकार को, तो इसलिए वो कोशिश कर रहे हैं. जबकि जो मुझे यहाँ पे दिख रहा है कि मैं अपने चारों तरफ देख पा रहा हूँ, जो स्पीसीज जो हैं जिनको वो रेयर स्पीसीज कहते हैं और बहुत कई सारी यूनिक स्पीसीज हैं, तो वो सारी चीज़ें जो हैं जो अपने आप में जो सिर्फ नेचर ही क्रिएट कर सकता है वो सारी खत्म हो जाएंगी और जो वहाँ का जो कंक्रीट है वो यहाँ पे आ जाएगा.
Looking at the health implications of PLPA, now the Supreme Court has intervened and there is a temporary stay. But the agitators are not satisfied. They say they will not stop until there is a complete rollback on the entire amendment. The question before them is very simple. It's about the green lungs of the National Capital Region, and one which they wish to carry to the upcoming elections as well. As they say, simply put, it is going to be development versus the environment. Sonal Mehrotra Kapoor for NDTV.